go from 25 to 12, or from 14 to 7, minimum 7% additional production capacity you've got for the same wires. 7% additional production capacity. But it will not give you 7% extra output. It can give you 14% extra output. Because the 7% are creating all kinds of bottlenecks. The moment they are in line, you might be able to get 12 to 14% extra output. Now, some people have resigned to fate, saying that this industry is like this only, and always the 40, sometimes 12, sometimes 16. But nothing can be done. But some people are doing things differently. And they have actually been able to bring down the absenteeism tremendously. And many companies have gotten to recruit have got some unbelievable results. They themselves are shocked. One company last Diwali, post Diwali, they were so excited, they said, sir, never in the history of the company. Worker present, we have about 80% attendance on first day after Diwali, which was absolutely unbelievable. This is what they reported back. So something, you know, there are things which can be done provided our mind allows us to do it. Our mind gets used to seeing things in a particular way and it becomes insensitive. And we realize this is what the reality is. Because we are not seeing a different reality. There's no way to do it. Human mind, seeing is beginning. So obviously 14% absenteeism, so 14% absenteeism reality plan based on that. But that makes your overhead to go higher. That gives you, so most companies in carpet industry in India, instead of there are 300 machines, there are 200 workers. The ones with the 1,000 machines, there are 700 workers. So 30% of the production capacity overheads is sitting idle, it's not producing. If that is the case, something drastically needs to be done about it. Because in that way, we will keep on losing our potential sales and potential profits. And that's what makes you eventually non-competitive. Any questions till now? I have spoken enough and there is a forced break. Anybody would like to raise a question?
தமிழ கேட்க விரும்புறவங்க கேட்கலாம்.
எஸ் எஸ்
சார்,
எஸ்
இன் தி பெர்செப்ஷன் ஆஃப் சோர்சிங் யூ செட் தி எஃபிஷியன்சி இஸ் ஒன்லி 3.9%
நோ நோ 3.9%
நோ 3.9 அவுட் ஆஃப் 10
ஹ ஆன் எ ஸ்கேல் ஆஃப் 1 டு 10
வாட் டஸ் இட் எக்ஸாக்ட்லி மீன்ஸ்
லைக் இட் மீன்ஸ் தட் யூ நோ ஆக்சுவலி இட் மீன்ஸ் இன் அ வே it's about 39%. It's not mathematically proven, but in the perception, that's what they feel. If the international benchmark is 10, we are 3.9, because we are 18 on a scale. But actually, in numbers, it is true that average Indian garment factory's efficiency is ranging between about 30 to 50%.
Is it saving efficiency?
This is mainly, when we talk about garment industry, mainly start referring to sewing efficiency because that's the most labor intensive activity as such. Okay? But you can also do much wider calculations and so on. But broadly speaking, they're not off. They're not off. That is what the broad reality is. Okay? See, what happens is, we must understand, how do we lose production? Where are we lose production? So many companies will say that this is not good because my factory, I achieved even 60 efficiency. That's true. Okay. What is important to be known is every hour of the factory costs us money at a factory level. And every square foot of my factory costs me money. Every square foot of my factory must produce money. Every hour of my factory must produce money. So, maybe 50% of the working time, my factory achieves 60 efficiency. Now, human mind will remember that 60. Now, 50% of the time, it achieves maybe 40 efficiency. 25% of the time, it achieves 20 efficiency. And 15% of the time, it achieves only 5 efficiency. Because there are learning curves involved, there are some times when the lines are starting, the approvals have not come, the fabric has not come, some machine break out, this type of all kind, you know, some chutti, new year, bongo, ugali, all kinds of things. So average will work out to be 40. So we must understand that when you're looking at the business performance, you're looking at the end of the year, 365 days put together or 280 working days put together, what have you achieved? Total number of workforce employed in the factory and the total output, 280 working days. Okay? Straight can give you a very simple number for every person employed, starting from MD to the last person, how many pieces they will produce. And sometimes if you do the calculation, and in nets it works out little different, but not too different. Many a times, organized garment factory's efficiency or productivity starts sounding similar to a tailoring shop. Because when you go to a tailoring shop, a tailor was doing individual shirt, a good tailoring shop, a tailor will produce about 8 to 10 shirts a day. 8 shirts he will produce. Okay? Average garment factories in India, in spite of all the technologies and so on, will also produce about 10 shirts, not more than that. So the difference between the tailoring shop and the garment factory is not much, in spite of economies of scale, in spite of high investment per person and things like that, because you keep on losing here, there, all put together, your efficiency is not the way it should be. Because you lost on so many accounts. That small volume chart that fills the room supervises 10 people. So in spite of being each chart being individual, still the person is able to get that kind of numbers. In other industries, say spinning industry, with the advent of technology, productivity per person increased about 1,000 times from the manual methods to the technological methods. But in the garment industry, in spite of high technology coming in, the increase in productivity, quantum, with the use of technology is very, very minimal. It's very, very minimal. Understand? You all understand in this way, you understand spinning. Okay, you have norms for spinning productivity, right? But if you look at the history, the spinning for output per person when the manual spinning was there, then various kind of technology, each technology got a quantum jump in the productivity. In garment industry, unfortunately, we are not able to tap the potential of technology because we are not able to bring our human systems to optimal level. Because there are too many imbalances. And every imbalance has a rippling effect on the entire manufacturing process, on the entire output. Is it okay? So we move forward. Does that answer the question?
Thank you.
So in fact, I did not think from that point of view. When I looked at the 3.9, they are virtually on the lot. And of course, because these are people knowledgeable about the garment industry, they need good factories day in and day out. So what happens is, lesser absenteeism and lesser attrition, and on both fronts, they have some very, very impressive results. At the end, what happens? You have better output quality, you have on-time delivery performance, you're more profitable than earlier, you're making less profit than earlier, depends on where your starting point is. The workforce are more engaged because you see a relationship between the improvement process and their well-being. So now they start trusting more because they don't see, you know, disconnect. Okay? Automatically, the need for at least unplanned overtime is not there. The workers are also able to plan their life. They are able to come to the factory on a more frequent basis. They will not run away, and then get 4 more people into the factory. It's a double bonus, okay? Even supervisors, managers are less stressed. When you are less stressed, your mind can actually plan. When you are under stress, you cannot plan. You are only firefighting. The moment you start planning better, your execution is likely to be much better than I did. All this will be seen by customers as a better performance. More predictable performance, which brings you more business, because suddenly now a buyer can see you as a different supplier than others. You get into the top 10%. The moment you get into the top 10%, the buyer is able to discuss business with you for coming 3 years. He will not discuss with anybody, but he would like to have some supplier with whom he can share the future strategy. Isn't it? That can happen. So this is what is the crux of our way of working. and connecting all these things together at a factory level, not in isolation. Okay? Of course, this can happen only if the top management is itself is informed, is convinced about it, is able to talk to the management team. Masters, financial managers, shipping managers, IAs, merchants, that this is what we believe in, this is what we want to happen. Then there is no doubt in anybody's mind that why we are doing this. We are not doing this because other people are telling us to do. We are not doing this because Tesco is telling us to do. We are doing it because we believe in it. We believe that future of our industry, our organization, is virtually supported by this kind of thinking, holistic thinking. Once these horses, which are moving in different directions, they start seeing the same future of the company, then automatically the synergy starts coming in. Otherwise, merchants are blaming production, production is blaming I, quality is blaming production, and the life goes on. As a result, we do not get 1+1=0. And that's not the problem in many organizations as such. So that synergy needs to be brought in. We move forward specifically. So what is the strategy all about? Is the idea clear? How each of us are doing? In many cases, many meetings in the factory, we go talk to management. The HR is not present, is not called for the meeting. It is a compliance meeting, the HR is there, nobody else is there. Isn't it?
Yes.
You handle it. Don't bother us. Productivity meeting, HR is not there. But you have 14% absenteeism, you've got 20% turnover. How can the HR not be part of any strategic discussion? In many cases, HR is only the payroll handling mechanism, nothing more than that. And what is handling mechanism? There are no strategic goals to play. You don't do virtually anything about HR. You talk to HR managers, do you carry out, do you interview workers?
Most elements will come.
But what are you talking about? I have an HR manager with 20 years of experience. Looking at the worker, I know exactly what he is thinking. And looking at 3 hours worker, I know exactly what 3,000 workers are thinking. I should not be wasting my time. I should be doing payroll administration. And better working. So many times, the so-called HR is averse to talking to workers. So-called HR is not letting the management policies known to workers. So you've got some beautiful policies. As a vision, the managing director or chairman of the company actually has a good vision. If you want to do this, you want to do worker welfare. But if you go and ask 50 workers, how many of them actually know about these policies? Depending on the company, very few will actually know. But if they actually knew, then their thinking about the company and the management will be different. But that is not being done. That is not being done. And if you are really looking at growing as a manufacturing destination, then workers must feel that they have a future in the companies. Company values them, not in the policies, values them in action. And who lives with them? Supervisors live with them. But has this vision been shared with supervisors? Have the supervisors been taught in terms of how to lead the workers? It's not, unfortunately. And that's what is one of the biggest bottlenecks in the industry. And again, the contact system comes in a way of doing all these things. But he says that you take care of your business, I take care of my business. As a result, there's a wall between. You don't know actually what's happening in the worker's mind. It needs to be thought about. I'm not saying the contact system is all bad, there are no resentments, but we must understand if we are not able to connect to workers, if they are not able to connect to us, we will remain in back. And that is not a very good situation to have. Let's move forward quickly now. So, what are the key areas that is important potential? I've taken again a company-wide view. We'll go into some deeper in some areas. The company cost of quality is a major area where we can save a lot of money at a reputation level. And I'll explain what cost of quality is. Strengthening HR systems and employee engagement is a very, very important area, especially because we are facing labor shortage. If you're not facing labor shortage, If the labor turnover was 2% a month, if the absenteeism was 2% a month, maybe I would not take this as a priority item. But that doesn't exist. That is a dream for companies to have. We have some companies actually operating at 1.2% labor turnover in garment industry. Lean thinking and waste elimination. Identifying waste throughout supply chain constantly and evaluating it one by one as a strategy that everybody in the organization understands what waste means. Company by training is very, very important. You can't fight the modern day battle with the boy and all soldiers. Can you do that? You cannot. So, today's factories need to be run in a particular way. So, we must be able to train our people to be able to follow the systems which are internationally acceptable, where the buyer comes in and he doesn't need to ask anything. But he says, oh, wow, this is very nice. I have not seen this anywhere else. Can I take a picture? Can I take it to my practice? That is happening. That is happening in many cases where the buyers are getting good ideas from our shop floor. But that needs to happen in a much wider way, in a much consistent way. So maybe there are lots of good practices which are already existing in Bhopal, but they are not cross-fertilizing between the companies. And this forum will actually play that role in terms of how to connect these bright minds. So that is the mutual learning. And this platform is really, really good. Now, yesterday I shared that I worked with a cluster in Delhi by Bhopal Garment and Textile Cluster. It's a small cluster. There were about 25 other companies and about 100 factories. But they really work very, very close together. They share capacities, they do common sourcing, they do common negotiation of rates with suppliers, technology providers, they get common consulting services, use them under common training, they have a conference, annual conference, and it's a good example of how things can work. They have a monthly meeting in one of the member factories. And post-meeting, they go for a walk. And first time when the member secretary had proposed that we should do like that, so that the member obliged, couldn't say no. So they went for a meeting. And post-meeting, the director of business, the very senior textile professional, he said, we'll walk around. He said, go for a walk? What do you mean? Yes, we go for a round. And again, he was, now he's a host. Is kind of under, you could not say no. Anyway, so reluctantly the members ended around. Then one of the members said, look, you have this computer embroidery machine, it's by written. Yes, I don't have embroidery orders. I have not embroidery orders. So why not you do it from? Yes, possibly. Then of course another place, Kansai machine is a huge amount of WIP. So what is this? So yeah, I have only four Kansai machines. Why more for consent? Oh, I got some spare Kansai machines there. So if you want, you can pick it up. So that's how it started actually. And as a practice, that every monthly meeting happens in one of the factories and they go out. What it did was, it really suddenly opened people's mind that so much we can do together to help each other without being affecting our competitiveness. And it really worked. So what? This is actually an example of friends working today a little bit. The 25 have a very good friends and do lots of things because the mind is open. So they actively criticize each other, they share the practice, I do it like this, I do it like this, I do it like this, and really they're able to move forward. So come and they do lots of training. Company-wide training. And they're training on all kinds. Okay? Supply chain improvements, we talk about that, and excellence in product development. How much you do it one time? What's the time like?
11:15.
Now for the people who not heard, how many people have heard the term cost of quality? Can you raise your hand? You heard the term cost of quality. Or you know about it, you read an article about it. Not many people. Okay. So let me share exactly what it is. Because your buyer quality manual will not talk about cost of quality. It doesn't figure there. Barring exceptions, maybe something there. Cost of quality means if God gave you a blessing that my son, my brother, in your factory, nothing will go wrong. Even if you want to, nothing will go wrong. Also your suppliers also are dressed in the same way. Then in their suppliers, nothing will go wrong. Also in the way of transportation, nothing will go wrong. Okay? Your actual cost of manufacturing will be X. 200 rupees a piece. 150 rupees a piece, depending on what product you are doing. Under the basis of the car, nudging cannot go wrong. So then you have nudging going wrong as a guarantee by God. Would you like to have quality inspectors?
No.
I want everybody to think. If God gives a guarantee, nothing can go wrong. Would you still need quality inspectors?
No.
Everybody thinks so?
No.
Well, so you don't require quality inspectors. No need for sending the samples to SGS or ITS or whichever company you sent to. No need to give this $500 or $400 per sample. No need to hire a quality manager because nothing can go wrong in quality. No need to buy extra habit. Right now, what percentage of extra habit will buy because of the quality problem? What percentage?
5%.
3 to 5 to 7. Okay, I'll give you what 3 numbers. See, we know the spectrum. So, no need to buy 3 to 5% of extra habit. There will not be. There's no discussion out there. So, management has not think about all these things. So, the cost of manufacturing will be X. But unfortunately, God hasn't given us that price. That blessing is not there. So, currently, our cost of manufacturing is X plus. Is some rupees more than 150 rupees. Okay. Cost of quality is the gap between 150 rupees and your current cost. The current cost will be 155 or it may be 180. How much it is, I don't know today. Because I have not examined, I have not come and seen the patient, I have not taken your blood pressure, I have not spoken your ECG and things like that, so I don't know. That is called cost of quality. That the amount of money you lose or spend because you are not 100% sure about your quality. So, what I did, we did a study in India, looked at 61 companies across the country, including Tirupur, including Kolkata, Ahmedabad, Delhi, Bombay, Tirupur, Bangalore, Nils, Bowens, Delhi, Venture, Women's, or everything put together. We found out how much money the companies lose on account of poor quality. In terms of financial number. And we found out average factory has 14% of sales. How much? 14% of sales on account of poor quality. The good news is that 25% of the companies, about 15 companies, their average cost of quality was 6.4%. 6.4% of sales. So average national average was 14%. The good rule was 6%. So our conclusion was that an average factory can reduce their cost of quality by 8% of sales. 8% of sales, average factory. Now, you may be a standard product producer. So your cost of quality might not be average. You lower than the average. Does not matter. Other conclusion is you may be any company at any level of maturity. If you work on it, the savings through cost of quality will be highly lucrative in terms of real savings a company can get. And we have examples in Tirupur and Gordon yesterday shared this example. There are a lot of other examples. We save 5% on sales. Your profitability can be 50% up. That was my slide earlier showed that producing less cost and quality, you can improve your profitability of 50%. So it is not an academic based on some theory, and all theories are actually out of practice. No theory falls on the scrap. Okay? if many times we have this ambiguity of the question of discounting theory, saying that it's wrong theory, nothing. No theories come from this guy. Somebody observes, somebody carries out experiments, somebody does a lot of data analysis, and they come out with these things. There's another company which already was doing reasonably well, and their primary quality was cut to ship loss. Mainly cut to ship loss. How many pieces do you buy, how many pieces do you ship, how much is the difference between them? And in cut to ship loss, we also count the number of samples given to buyer. Even that is counted, because every piece cut must be accounted for. Some may be available, some may not be available. So we must know how many there are. Because sometimes the buyer needs first. The cut-to-ship loss was 1.59%. 1.59. That means you are going to ship 100 garments, they got 101.59. So we told you at the start of the program, don't worry. Your performance is decent, you are one of the better companies around. But number one, don't get complacent. That you achieve everything, so don't need to do anything. Number two, don't worry. You work on this path, you will get results. And your results will be satisfactory. You will work it. And the GM actually this actually huge in sense is a relative term. I think we had about 15 production lines or so in the financial reporter. It's another company in Delhi, NITS Integrated. This company, the management will try to persuade them and motivate them to act. Initially, like a big elephant, they won't listen. They are their own musty. After 3 months, somehow we were able to make them listen. Then please do something about it, you'll be able to save a lot of money. So finally, a GM was there. He found some sense in the words. They worked for 3 months. These companies on record, they saved 3 crores flat in 3 months, only by improving cut-to-ship loss. And at the end of the program, the person came, of course, it's large manufacturing capacity, 80 million mix. And they said, sir, actually we have said 3.3 crores, and we started late, but we'll continue to do so. Will they continue or not? I don't know. It depends on the management. Sometimes the large companies are running by development, the MD program might not go along that this thing has happened. And if he doesn't ensure that this continues, they might go back to their own performance. The question is, are you willing to do it right? Are you able to bring the systems? Are you able to follow up on those? Because a lot of your own money, you should be coming to the company, goes down the drain. Okay? So, average the top group is 6.1%, average factor is 14%. Another company in Delhi NCR, and the last NCR was here also, they do mainly for Europe. Their average capacity projection was 4%. In about 4 months time, 5 months time, they went down to about 2%, 2% of sales, about 20% of profit. Okay. So I'm just going to leave that cost of quality there. There are articles on find on the internet. Go on the internet, download it, start reading. The fact that you're reading about it will give you some idea, some transfer action, start doing those actions, some improvement will come somewhere. There's a need to understand that better. Strengthening HR systems and worker engagement is a big topic. There can be a day, a 3 day, a 7 day, some training program on this itself. But what are the areas? Priority of role of HR. Are you a payroll administrator? Or are you something to do with HR? Do you think human as a resource? Role of HR. Dosi was called the service organization. And what do you mean by service organization? What is the meaning of service? When we use the word service, what do you mean by that? Okay. When we say the word service, what does it mean? In Tamil also.